name's John Stevens. I'm with Total Escape Games. I'm here with Back to Dials, and I am joined again in the booth by John Grasser. John lost last round, sadly.
Sad face.
This is four straight top fours?
Yes. No, I made top eight in one, top four in two others, and a finals in the other.
Wow. Well, you got 2 weeks, and you're doing it again in Plano?
Yes.
So we'll do it again. On the left, we've got Evan Claassen. We watched Evan play last round here. On the right, we've got Jonathan Reinig. Interesting for me, Mr. Reinig is the defending world champion in Armada.
He is.
Let's talk about John's list. We haven't seen it yet today.
I actually played this last round. So Dengar, very good. Bossk is insane with the way he has it set up. It's actually not cluster missiles that are listed on there. He has concussion missiles. And what he's going to do with this is he's going to shoot Dengar with the plasma torpedoes to clear the shields on his first target, whoever that may be, and then he will follow it up with the concussion missiles. Now, as long as he rolls two hits on those concussion missiles, he's going to get another hit and a crit from the concussion missile and the guidance chip, which then commands an automatic five hits, which then he follows off their focus tokens, and because of crack shot, he guarantees almost five hits.
Oh.
It is very brutal, very good. It's tough. We'll leave it at that.
Wow. Okay.
It's tough.
And Kyle, or Lee downstairs, one of the two, has gotten us switched, so Bossk is showing us concussion missiles now.
Mm-hmm. The Dengar he has is just really good stuff. It's, you know, recon spec R4, agromac plasma torpedoes with guiding chips and things like this. It's just an all-around good ship.
So we talked about it last round when Nathan was in the booth with me. Tell's got Boba Fett. Who's the target on the other side of the table? What's the upgrade you're going to strip when you get a chance with Boba Fett here?
Boba Fett on the other one? Punishing one on Dengar.
You're stripping the tempo.
I think so.
That extra red die.
I think so, yeah.
Okay.
I think it makes Dengar just that little bit less impressive. Unless he can get Tell. I don't know how initiative is going to work here. I don't know who has initiative.
So the players have dials down.
And depending on initiative,
waiting for them to move.
That could make a difference, because if Dengar doesn't have a target lock, he can strip Deadeye potentially with Tell off of Dengar. Or the missile off of Bossk. So then Bossk can't use his ability with the missile, right? So then it's just a regular attack, which could be very interesting. We'll see. And it looks
so
like
Dengar is moving first. So
looks
Jonathan
like John does have the initiative.
Or Bossk is moving first. Sorry, backwards here.
I did the same thing.
They're all starting to look the same at this hour, to be honest. I think somebody recently mentioned we've been up for 14 hours at this point. I feel a little bad for the Twitch stream. They've been listening to me for most of those 14 hours.
I feel bad for your voice.
Meh, whatever. We're going to do it again for Armada.
Yeah, right? Be back here tomorrow.
I don't know anything. I've played one game of Armada ever.
Okay.
Should be a fiasco.
Right. Well, I mean, we got Nathan Bolander, who was on here earlier. He's never played Armada, and he's actually going to participate tomorrow in Armada for the first time. It'll be awesome.
Nate's going to win this thing.
Yeah. He's got this locked up.
We only got
the world champion in the house, whatever.
So Dengar's making a two turn here, and John's decided to pull one of those pegs out of Dengar and lower him to the table a little bit here. Focus on Dengar. Oh, I didn't notice Recon Specialist. I had to look at the screen and go, focus, what happened?
Yeah. It's really good because of, with R4 Agromech, he gets target locks, focuses everywhere. It's really good.
Zuckus with the move, takes token, doesn't matter. Tokens are going to come off of all of these guys now, and we're back to dials. Here in the finals.
So I think Paleb is going to be coming up from the side and just trying to be a general nuisance, maybe even a deal sealer. Coming in, he's going to get Tell to do some work in there with the proton torpedoes. He's going to have Zuckus do some damage with whatever he's going to be shooting, whoever his first target's going to be, being Dengar or Bossk. I'm not 100% certain. And then he'll use Paleb to finish him off with the TLT and to strip tokens to make it easier.
So are you hoping this round to get Tell in a position to fire the first rockets?
See, I don't know if Evan sees it and knows how this is going to work. I think he does because he knows Jonathan. They come, you know, once Jonathan's from Kansas City, Evan's from Omaha.
Yes, we have an out-of-state final. So yeah, yeah. It hurts my Colorado soul a little bit.
Really? Did you have anybody in the top four? Was the other gentleman that made top four, was he Colorado?
No. I believe we had an out-of-state top four.
Wow. Mm-hmm. What happened?
Man,
last year you had three of the four. I was the only one out of state. Yeah, now it's all out of staters. Man, we're invading. It's all over with. Anyway, so Bosk coming in hard. Bosk is going to use Bosk's ability, and I think he's just going to try to pick up Zuckus super quick.
Takes a focus here.
Gets the target lock because he has R4.
Gets the target lock.
Or K4, sorry, K4.
And Palop making that move towards the I don't want you to have focus tokens area.
Right.
And Palop takes a focus token. So one bank here.
The only concern I have is
focusing.
Dengar going to be able to move in and grab a do what he needs to do? Looks like he's going to be just in range 3, which is perfect.
Dengar's going to get to fire those plasma torps, yes.
Yep. That's going to be a dead Zuckus. I'm interested that he went after Zuckus first. Okay.
Zuckus, the little short move there. Evan's debating Zuckus' action here.
Because the problem is Fulham. Fulham's going to make it work either way. And since it's a plasma torpedo, even taking the evade doesn't guarantee that he won't be one-shotted.
I think we can probably just go home if that happens.
That's a little preemptuous. I mean, Tell doesn't die and then dies and then doesn't die again. Like he just does a.
Yeah. Tell sticks around. Evan's playing with a token there in his hand, but he's looking at the plasma torpedoes on Dengar, trying to decide what the plan is here. Confirming that there is a target lock on Zuckus.
I think
wondering whether or not Zuckus lives through the exchange.
I was going to say, I feel like Evan just figured out what was going to happen. He's a quick guy. He knows his stuff. He's been playing for a while. I think he just figured it out. He's like, this is not a good spot to be in.
Yes.
I think he just figured it
out. So Dengar's firing first here.
Yep. He's in Deadeye. Gets his plasma off.
See plasma torps go here and a target lock go up. Spending the target lock here, rerolling 2 with 2 hits on the table. Gotta get that one in the box. Can't get it in the box still. John pushes some to the side and finally gets it. We've got 3 hits and a crit there.
Nothing.
All 4 shields are going to come off Zuckus. We're going to take him from 4 shields to 0.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, you can't read those.
Zuckus will get to shoot this turn, luckily. But it's going to be a dead Zuckus.
Zuckus is next to fire here. At Bosk, we're going to add one on both sides.
Hit crit
in the box. Get a target lock. 1 evade. That was at Bosk there?
No. That was at Bosk, because he rolled the additional attack.
So
die.
Bosk is going to lose a shield there. Passing dice around the table here.
The white ones are very hard to see.
The white ones are very hard to see on camera. Bosk concussion missile here. And a focus and a guidance chips.
It's a dead Zuckus. It's a dead Zuckus. Even with the 2, because he's going to crack shot. And then he can use Bosk's ability to add 2 for the crit.
Yep, that's exactly what happens. And there goes Zuckus. Guys are talking about the volume in the Twitch channel. The shop has started to close down a little bit. There's very few people in the room. John and I have to go to our very Masters Golf Tournament voices. Even though we're 25 feet above the table, they can still hear us.
I will try to speak louder into the mic. I'm sorry about that.
Zuckus does leave the table there.
Ooh. Ooh. Nice hit. Nice hit on Bosque. Bosque to take four. Five because of... No. It's Proton. Sorry.
Bosque loses four shields there. Bosque is down to one shield after that. So Bosque goes from 6-1 because we had one come off earlier when Zuckus attacked.
Caleb being a little too slow. Didn't get a shot.
In the channel, they're asking how Zuckus died. Zuckus got hit with plasma torps, then with concussion missiles and a guidance gem and a crack shot. And I think there was a whole bunch of other stuff in there. But the important thing...
I'll walk them through it again. So Dengar shot. When Dengar shot, he hit with the plasma torpedoes. The plasma torpedoes stripped all the shields off of him. Bosque then shoots with concussion missile. He has a K4, green maneuver, gives him the target lock. Uses the target lock because he takes the focus action to shoot the concussion missile. The concussion missile then changes one of the blanks that he had to a hit. Then he changes another blank that he had to a crit. And he had it was hit focus, and he had the focus, so then it became three hits and a crit. Then he has an evade, and the evade that he naturally rolled, he uses crack shot to make it only one evade, so now then three are getting through, but then he spends the crit on with using Bosque's ability to add two damage.
So we started our movement in this next round here. Bosque made a little bank maneuver, took a target lock on Pelop near the middle of your screen there. He also is going to successfully block that scout, it looks like.
Yep.
We're just going to sort of shove him a little forward and pull him off his base. That empty base is Tell. Not a scout. I'm so used to seeing scouts, I just keep calling all of them scouts.
Might as well.
Pelob with a short move and a focus. Dengar with a hard turn to the left.
This isn't the best look for Pelob, if we're honest.
Dengar focuses twice with that recon specialist. Pelob steals it. Dengar will shoot first here. He's going to plasma torpedo again. So Dengar will be out of munitions after this attack on Pelob.
Guidance chips up the hit.
Guidance
keeps the target lock. Goes to a crit.
Goes to a crit.
Because of the
hits,
punishing one.
Two crits.
So he's going to take two crits. Pelob will.
He loses the shield. He's going to take two crits. Structural and a damaged cockpit. Pelob's going to go from four hull to two in that exchange. Bosque at Pelob is range three and through a rock. Target lock to reroll those two eyeballs. We have two hits in the box. Oh, only one focus. Pelob will spend the focus to stay alive. So Pelob's going to get to fire some TLTs here. No actions. Oh, they rolled too many dice. Yeah, it works out okay.
spends the focus and takes zero. Pelob will stay at two. Nothing on the first one. Second one does result in Bosk taking a damage, so Bosk will lose his last shield. Range 2 attack from Tell. One hit, and an evade there from Dengar. We are planning again here. I'm particularly curious as the players are working their dials. What are we looking for from Tell and Bosk at the top of your screen? They're currently kissing face up there.
Well, I think Tell's going to... I feel like Tell has to sloop here. Bosk is a stop, is a concern, and I'm not 100% certain that sloop 2 will actually clear, but Tell kind of has to get back in that fight. Otherwise, he's just not... He or she, I don't even know, isn't doing a whole lot, right? And I feel like Pelob has to kind of go up and get blocking and get behind Bosk and start doing some things. We'll see.
Pelob's going two straight here, it appears.
Yeah, he's trying to set up a block for Dengar. Start some action denial.
Bosk goes one forward. Activates K4, takes a target lock on Pelob.
Right. That was the stop I was concerned about. Tell doesn't move because he didn't read that he was going to be moving or that was going to be blocking.
And we're going to see Dengar plow into Pelob here.
Mm-hmm.
Might not be a bad thing for Pelob, something not shooting at it.
Right, right. Well, the problem is there's the target lock from Bosk.
Yes.
Right. That could be rough.
So Dengar at Tell here, range 2. One hit. No evade there. Tell loses a shield. Goes from 4 shields to 3 here. Bosk is range... It is range 2 and a rock. So range 2 and a rock. Target locking everything.
Two hits
here.
Ooh, hey. Pelob finally starting to decide. Again. No rock. Oh, did they?
Mm-hmm.
That'll kill.
Pelob only loses one there, despite Evan reaching to pick Pelob off the table. Pelob's alive still. TLT through the rock. 2 hits. Takes 1. Bosk loses a hull there. Bosk loses a hull there. Bosk is down to 4 hull. The players are down there, and I'm the only one that can hear them. They're in my headphones, and nobody else. But the players are down there going, "God, why are they recording this? We're exhausted and playing."
Yeah.
It has been a long day of X-Wing. If you weren't with us in the beginning, we went on the air at about 8:45 Mountain Time. That is now 14 hours ago.
I agree with the comments. John has not been using Forlorn the correct way on Bosk. Otherwise, Pelob should be dead already.
And again, we've been here for 14 hours.
A while. Or just Crackshot, because I don't think the Crackshot was used. I'm sorry.
Yes, Crackshot has been used. And as much as I want Crackshot to be more than one use...
True story.
John doesn't realize he's not on camera, so he just gave me a silly look and a nod.
Words can't describe it. Multiples of those seems pretty ridiculous, if we're honest.
That Palob turn will miss the rock.
That was very well done.
We put a token on Palob there. Bosk goes one forward, which means Bosk doesn't move again.
I'm not sure he's an arc, but it's definitely going to be a range 3.
It is range 3. It may or may not be an arc. It's hard to tell straight up because that ship does a good job of blocking the side arcs on it. That is just a right bank.
Mm-hmm.
Which clears Tell past Bosk.
Evan's not out of this yet. I mean,
Evan's not out of this yet.
If he has some nice moves, you know, a little fancy flying.
Soft 2 from Dengar to the right there. I expect that Dengar is going to... Yep, we're going to double focus on Dengar again. Palob will get to steal one of those, of course.
Yep. I'm not sold on that being the right move, if I'm honest. Taking the double focus. I think you're just feeding more to the fire to try to keep Palob around, right?
2 hits and a crit. 2 hits and a crit on Palob means...
A dead Palob.
Palob is leaving the table. So Palob goes down here. We still have Tell. Tell's got 3 shields and 5 hull, as well as the I'm going to come back after you kill me the first time. Tell gets a pair of hits there.
He's considering spending the focus to grab a target lock to get a reroll on that die.
And that's exactly what he's going to do. Focus, target lock, reroll that die, 3 hits. Taking 2. Bosk does get an evade die there. Bosk goes down to 2 hull on that attack. Where we're getting real close to seeing Dengar Vitel.
If it's Dengar Vitel, Evan has a chance. He has
Evan
a proton.
Does have a chance.
He has a proton left, right? And if he gets enough that he gets shield down, that proton can do that crit. That gets some work done. A blinded pilot skill 0.
There's a lot of things that can happen if we end up at Denver.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Palob is gone from the table. The guys down in the tech booth have not quite caught up. Palob will turn gray here pretty soon. Players are making their planning again. So all of our dials are on the table. Where's Tell going?
Tell's going to hard one.
Tell's going to hard one.
Tell's going to hard one.
No chance that sticks Tell on that asteroid?
No. I don't think so. Although I'll be honest with you, I can't see from up here. I can't. I have looked at these, and I'm like, no, this guy's good. No, this guy. And I'm wrong. I've been wrong like every single time. So I'm probably the worst person to ask.
Straight maneuver from Bosk.
Grabs a target lock, does a focus.
Yep.
Oh, goes sloop.
That is the sloop from Tell. Maybe one day they'll put Tell back on the peg.
It's called cloaking. He's cloaked.
Tell's cloaked.
Yes. Tell's cloaked.
Cannot take a target lock because Tell does not have Dengar in range. Dengar K turns. Dengar and Bosk are out of torpedoes. The players are confirming that with one another. The only torpedoes left are the proton torpedoes on Tell.
Bosk is going to try to spend the next couple turns trying to come back around, wheel that big bus around.
It'll take time. That bus doesn't move well.
Nope. So we're going to have a joust of Tell versus Dengar here in a minute.
So we clear some tokens because nobody's shooting at anybody that round. And dials are back down on Bosk and Dengar. Dengar is now, in case you can't tell because that Jumpmaster takes up a lot of space above the base, Dengar is facing towards the middle of the field, towards Tell. Bosk's bus is faced the wrong direction. What are the hard turn options for Bosk? Anything?
Hard three, maybe. I think it puts him on a rock too much. I think you're going to have to sloop it. I think you're going to have to just bank it out and then go from there. Yeah, he's going to bank three.
He's going to bank three. My only thought with the hard three is if it's a possible maneuver there, it might get that side arc a little closer to where we want to be with Tel.
Yeah, I agree.
But those hard threes are white, and they're going to stick you on an asteroid. The hard twos are red.
Yeah, you couldn't hard two. The hard twos are absolutely going to put you on a rock.
Correct.
Hey, decloaked. Tel, slow rolling.
Tel with a little one move forward. That is the slowest of the slow rolls. Dengar with the two forward.
Still slow rolling.
Any thought here to blowing these proton torps on Dengar?
Oh. That's tough, man. You would like to see one shield gone, but he's going to have a bucket. I mean, just a bucket of focuses right here, right? I mean, I guess it kind of depends on what happens in the attack roll, right? If he whiffs out, you think you can get another turn in there.
Dengar attacks. He's going to spend a focus, get a target lock, use the target lock, hit, crit. Only one evade. Tel's going to lose two more shields in that exchange. Go from three shields to one. And at the table, they're holding the conversation that John and I just held. Do you fire the proton torpedo?
This goes back to the question you asked me before. What's better, plasma or proton? Like, this is a situation where you're like, if there was minus one shield or two shields, that proton is way deadlier. Way deadlier. You can pop that crit through. There's so many things. Does a primary attack, gets two hits, waiting for the evade roll. Grabs the target lock, though. Spend the focus. He's going to have two evades.
We get evade there?
It's focus evade. I don't know.
No, he's not going to use the focus because Dengar gets to fire back here.
Okay, fair enough. So he takes two. Oh. Brutal.
Three
brutal
blank dice from Tel.
Crit of?
Minor explosion.
Major explosion.
Major explosion, sorry.
Does another crit. Looks like damage sensor array.
Damage sensor array. Tel is down to two hull now and zero shields. That was brutal.
That was.
Dials have been picked up here. Despite Tel's ability to come back to life, this is looking really rough for Evan.
Dengar did take some damage there. This
Dengar
has not been updated.
He missed a shield.
Yep.
Dengar losing a shield there.
Here comes Bosk around in the boat.
Bosk makes that big turn in the boat there.
Does he rock?
Tell
he just rocks.
The rock is going to deal a point of damage to Tel. Tel has one hull left. A two forward runs Dengar into Tel. Dengar won't attack this turn. So Bosk can kill Tel. Tel's going to get to come back and shoot still. Going to spend the target lock to add to those two hits, get a third hit. Range two, they've decided. One damage. Tel is going to die and not die. So for the guys in the booth, nothing is going to happen. Tel loses all the face-up damage. Tel comes back into play with four face-down damage and still has one hull point, but Tel has died. And the next time Tel gets shot, we have a regional champion. That's the half-gray Tel. I love it. He's, from the guys in the back.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
the half-gray Tel. Tel has died once.
I like that. Very original. So, sort of dead, but not quite. He's mostly dead.
That's all it is.
Evan has announced downstairs, or Jonathan has announced downstairs, that he just has to not be stupid, and he should be in good shape.
Yeah, I agree with that. Big stop, I like that. Gonna cause Tell to bump.
I'm not sure that Tell fits in there at all.
Oh no. Does he move at all?
I'm not sure that Tell fits between Denver and Bosk. They're going to slide down there. So the bump hits Bosk, but it does clear Dengar, so he's not going to be right where he was.
Let's see if Dengar does the sloop. Or bank one.
Bank one, or hard one, sorry, from Dengar. Hard one to the right. Double focus on Dengar. Here comes a range one attack from Dengar. Target lock to pick up the two bad ones. Spend a focus to get another target lock. Double evade doesn't matter. Tell is going to take the final damage. Jonathan Reinig, your defending world champion Armada, is your regional champion today.
Well done, Jonathan. It's very well flown. Very well flown.
Is this a list, while we're sitting here and they're packing up, is this a list other people should consider?
Consider? Sure.
What are the challenges if I go, this was a ton of fun to watch, I'm going to fly Dengar Bosk?
Oh, it's absolutely a ton of fly. You have to get the alpha right. If you're not in the right spot for the alpha, it's not a good look. I'm not sure how it does against aces. I think it would be very, very good, but I could be wrong, right? Because if they're fast enough and they're mobile enough, they might be able to position after you, being that they're 100 points, right? You can dodge, and Bosk, we already know, we've stated a couple times, he's in a bus or a boat or whatever you want to call it today, right? He's in a boat or bus. So you're really dodging Dengar, and as long as you don't have arc, Dengar doesn't have arc on you, there's no torpedoes coming out. So, I mean, there's... Is it good? Yes. I think it's going to be player-based. Jonathan's obviously a very good player.
He's a very good player.
So he knows what he's doing.
Yes. So that does it for us today. We have been here for 6 rounds of Swiss, quarterfinals and semifinals and finals and an out-of-state finals that featured Omaha, Nebraska and Kansas City, Missouri. Kansas City has won a regional title that they came out here to Denver and stole. My name is John Stevens. For John Grasser sitting next to me, for Lee Haberthier and Kyle Flynn in the booth, for Tim Blakely and Lance Laux, who have been tournament organizers all day, we're going to sign off tonight, come back and do this tomorrow for Armada Regional Championships. Thank you for being with me, John.
No, John, absolutely thank you for putting this on. I really do appreciate it. And one more time, thank you to Nighthawk for letting us run here. This has been a great, great thing. And if you have a chance to get to Denver, go check out Total Escape Games. It's good stuff.
Thank you, sir. You have a great night out there in the world. We will be getting these on YouTube in the coming week for you. And the staff is currently working on typing up all of the top 8 lists so that you have access to those in the near future. Thank you very much, and good night.